Hey kids, today we're making cherry vanilla cupcakes just in time for Valentine's Day, but they can really be made for any day.
It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
All right, we're gonna start with three different bowls. In our first bowl, I am going to put in 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm just gonna stir that around, and we are going to put that on the side. In our next bowl, a smaller bowl, that was our medium-sized bowl, we are going to put in 3/4 cup of buttermilk and 1/3 cup of maraschino cherry syrup taken from a bottle of maraschino cherries. Now, if you are going to be decorating this with the maraschino cherries on top, get the ones with the stems because they'll be a lot prettier. I'm going to be doing something different. So let's put that on the side there. And in our last bowl, our nice big bowl, I am going to put in 1 stick of butter, which is 1/2 cup of butter. And that's been sitting at room temperature for at least 30 minutes. And I am going to be adding with my electric mixer on medium to high speed. I'm gonna mix this for about 30 seconds. And then I'm going to add in some other stuff. So let me get that taken care of. I'll be right back. To this, I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of almond extract. I'm using an almond emulsion, so it looks a lot thicker, but it is the same thing. And 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and I'm using vanilla paste, so it does seem a lot thicker. Same thing, only bumped up majorly in flavor. And then I am going to add 1 1/2 cups of sugar, and we are going to mix that until it is thoroughly mixed together. So we'll be back. I have also had sitting at room temperature for 30 minutes 4 egg whites. We're going to add 1 egg white at a time, and since they kind of sort of fall in like they do eggs, I just put them all in one bowl, but we're gonna just make sure that it's added before we add in the next one. So I'm gonna take care of all 4 and we'll be back. Meanwhile, I did preheat my oven to 350 degrees. The oven's already booped, and now we are going to start alternating with the dry and the wet. So I'm gonna put in a little bit of the flour stuff, and I'm gonna beat that in, and once that is combined, then I'm gonna put a little bit of the buttermilk maraschino cherry mixture in. And I'm just gonna keep alternating between the two until everything is combined. We'll be back. I did wanna show you when I added the maraschino cherry because it's gonna make it so pinky. Isn't that gonna be cool? Nice, nice, nice. So we're adding these in on low speed, and we're only doing it until it is well combined. Don't forget to scrape down the sides and get everything in there, which I'm gonna do right now. All right, so we all know how much I like to use the ice cream scoops to fill my cupcake, just to keep everything pretty uniform. You wanna fill it about 2/3 of the way. I think I'm putting it in a little bit too much. So I should probably ease up a tiny bit, but we're gonna be able to fill 24 cupcakes if I start easing up here. And we're gonna put that into our 350 degree oven for 18 to 19 minutes. And so let me continue that, put it in the oven, and we'll be back with our wonderful cherry almond cupcakes. So we'll be right back. Okay, I was able to get 21 because I overstuffed. So I will, whoops, sorry, 21. I'll be back. While these are going to be cooling, I am going to get out 2 sticks of butter, 1 cup, and I'm going to let them come to room temperature. We'll be back. All right, so I have on, there we go. Here, the 1 cup of butter that I have softened. And I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm going to cream this up just a bit. Now, I went ahead and I tasted the cupcakes, and they don't taste anything at all like the maraschino cherries, but it does taste a very subtle almond flavor to it. So because of that, I think what I want to try to do is not use the 1/2 teaspoon of almond extract that goes into the frosting. I'm just going to use the 3 tablespoons of maraschino cherry. So after you get that done, you put in about 2 cups of the four cups that you're going to use of powdered sugar. And then once you get that worked in, you can put in 1/2 of the maraschino cherry juice, and then add in the other 1/2 of the powdered sugar, and then the last 1/2 of the maraschino cherry juice. Something I did notice, that with the 10-ounce jar of maraschino cherries, it gave me almost exactly to the T the amount of liquid that you need. So for the first 1/3 cup, and then for the 3 tablespoons after that. So I don't know if that's coinkydink or if that's, you know, how the person who created the recipe's idea of, you know, of using it all up, but that was pretty cool. All right, so I'm just going to add in a little of the maraschino cherry juice. And then I'll continue until I have it all done, and then I'm going to put it in my piping bag, and I'm going to pipe it onto my cupcakes. We'll be back. I didn't add the last tablespoon, so I just added 2 tablespoons of the maraschino cherry juice. And tasting it, you can't taste, at least I can't, the maraschino cherry juice in this. It's just, you know, buttercream frosting, basically. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this all in here. And I'm just going to pipe my cupcakes. I saw Jen of Cupcakes and Cardio pipe a certain way, and I'm going to try to copy that technique because I liked the way it ended up and how she added on her sprinkles. So, hang on, let me go get my cucumbers. Let me go get my cupcakes. So first she just piped one nice round on there, and then put the sprinkles on that first layer, and then piped on the inside and top layer. Wish I could have the awesome angles that she has. And then she had those Ferrero Rochers or whatever, however you say it. But I have these Godiva truffles, and I thought that those would be really cute to add to the tops of these. So there you go, cherry vanilla cupcakes. Enjoy!
Goodbye. Make sure you comment and subscribe.